Hi guys, welcome back to Absolute Brushes. If you're new here, I'm Pranjali. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today, I'm gonna show you how to create these beachy waves using a flat iron. And if you're wondering about this look, I'll leave the link to this makeup tutorial in the description box down below for your convenience. So without further ado, let's get started. The things that you need for these curls are a heat protection spray, a comb, some clutchers, and a flat iron. So I'm first spraying some heat protection spray to my hair. This one's Blunt Hot Shot Heat Protection Mist, and as the name suggests, it will protect my hair from the heat damage from the flat iron. And because it has grapeseed oil and pro vitamin B5, it will also nourish my hair and not let it get dry. Once I'm done spraying my hair with this heat protection mist, I'll comb my hair so it can spread evenly throughout my hair, and you wanna wait for a few seconds till it dries down before you go in with your heat styling. Now that my hair have dried down, I'll section my hair to secure them with some clutches and I'll start to straighten my hair. This step is completely optional if you already have straight hair, but because my hair are wavy and I have some frizz in my hair, so to tame them down, I'm first straightening them with Philips PHS 386 Karashine Straightener. This will ensure that my curls come out very smooth and neat. Otherwise, you'll have some or the other baby hair poking out, which won't look so flattering. I'm not being too precious about straightening my hair, as I just want to tame them down and tame those frizzes and waves away. Also, once I'm done with straightening, I do leave my hair for a few seconds till they cool down. You don't want to immediately go into curling your hair after straightening them, as they are hot at that time and excessive heat can fry your hair, so you want to give it some time to cool down before you jump into curling them. So till the time they are cooling, let me show you the technique how I curl them. I'll take a small section of my hair and clamp it between my straightener, and I'll rotate the straightener outwards, almost creating a 180 degree turn, and I'll gently pull it through. Let me show you one more time. You want to clamp your hair, rotate it 180 degree outwards and pull it through. I always first practice this with my straightener off, and once I get the hang of it, I repeat it with my straightener on. Okay, now that I'm a little more confident, let's try this with my straightener on. Take a small piece of your hair, clamp it, rotate it outwards and pull through. Here you want to make sure that you are not taking big chunks of your hair, because then your curls will not be as tight. So the smaller the section of your hair, tighter will be your curl, and you wanna go slowly when you're going down so that your hair gets ample heat, otherwise it won't curl. So if you want your curl to be tighter, you need to go slow and don't clamp your hair too tightly between your straightener, as it will become tougher for you to rotate and pull through. Just hold it gently, not too tight, not too loose. As I reach closer to my face, the pieces of the hair I'm taking are getting smaller, because these pieces will be framing my face. So I want to keep these curls tighter. And one more thing, make sure you part your hair before you curl them, as parting them after curling them will loosen those curls. Now that I have reached to the front pieces here, I'll rotate my straightener outwards and I'll pull it away from my face, because I want my curls to curl away from my face and not fall directly in my face. And I'm mostly moving a little bit closer with these sections, as I don't want them to be too curly. Now that I'm done, I feel that these curls are a little too tight for my liking, so I'm loosening them a little with my fingers, and by the time I changed into my dress, they loosened up even more, so I'm just setting them a little with my fingers. And at this point, if you want, you can also spray some hairspray if your curls don't stay for long. And here is the finished result. I've paired it up with this gorgeous burgundy lip and a jumpsuit of the same color. Of course, you can pair it with anything you like. What I love about these curls are that they're so versatile and such a showstopper that even if you decide to go with a very simple attire, these curls will automatically up the game for you. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. And if you liked this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please take a moment to subscribe. I post new videos several times a week. In case you're wondering about this makeup look, I've left a link to this tutorial along with the products used and my socials in the description box down below. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.